Okay, what's going on this afternoon, you guys? This is the Fox J47, and I'm coming at you from Cashville. So, well, I'm kind of a little frustrated this evening, and just tired. I'm just tired. You know, you go to the doctors, and every doctor you go to, you have to pay a co-payment, you know. You know, you have to pay a co-payment of $20 every time you go to the doctor. And it just don't make sense to me. You know, every doctor, and I'm having to see 7 or 8 doctors, and I'm having to pay $20. And then when I get to each doctor, they want to send me to another doctor. Or they want to send me to therapy. You know, and each time you go to therapy, you're having to pay $20 too. They're asking you to go to therapy for 4 weeks, which is a month of you paying $20 to therapy, just to do whatever they do to you, because I've been so many times to therapy, and I've paid money out so many times to therapy, till even after the therapy that they gave me, I felt no better. I felt worse. And I'm just telling you the truth. I did. And, you know, every time you go to the doctor, that's the first thing they want to say. Oh, that's not really the first thing they want to say. The first thing, I'm just tired being fat, okay? Because I'm tired being fat. I'm tired being big. I'm tired of everywhere I go, somebody's got to say, it's because of your weight that this is happening to you. It is not because of my weight that this is happening to me. Now, let me go back again. My weight could cause an extra burden to what is happening to me. But my weight is not the reason why this is happening. And the reason why I know is because when I lost the 80 pounds, that's when everything came out then. I went and died, lost 80 pounds doing exercise. Y'all guys remember doing exercise, everything. Lost 80 pounds. Then after I lose the 80 pounds, then everything come out aching then. Okay? So every time you go to the doctor, they want to keep looking at you. I'm about sick of them. You're just too big, you're hurting, your knees hurting, your legs hurting, your feet hurting, your finger hurting, your eyeball hurting, your nose hurting, because you're fat. And I'm just so tired of it. And every doctor I go to, you want to try to force me to get weight loss surgery. What I want to know about weight loss surgery is, where was weight loss surgery 50 years from now? Where was weight loss? Was there a weight loss surgery 50 years from now? How were people losing weight 50 years from now? People who had aches and pains in their body and their knees were acting up. What was it that they took to help them? They sure didn't have no weight loss surgery back then. So now they act like weight loss surgery is your only surviving way out. And that's not my only surviving way out. I have insurance. Yeah, I can get weight loss surgery. But that is not my only way out of weight loss surgery that I have to get, that you have to make me, the doctors have to keep talking to me and trying to make me get weight loss surgery. Do I want to stop this hopping? Do I want to stop this aching? Stop this hurting? Yes. Do I? But do I want to put myself in a situation where some people go through weight loss surgery and some people come out wonderful, no problem at all, and some people come out terrible? Y'all know that. The weight loss surgery is not for everybody. It's not for everyone. Some people come out good. Some people don't come out at all. Okay? Let's face it. What was good for you may not be good for me. Let's understand that. So I'm just like, you know, just like fed up. You know, how's a doctor going to try to make me get weight loss surgery? Look, this is my body. This is my body. Okay, if I get weight loss surgery, something happens to me, I die or I get sick or something don't turn out right. This is not your body. So how is it that a doctor is going to insist that you have weight loss surgery? I'm not feeling that. I'm not feeling that. If I want weight loss surgery, I have weight loss surgery, but you're not going to make me get weight loss surgery. You're not going to make me do it. Okay, if I have to hop around the rest of my life hurting and aching, you're not going to make me get weight loss surgery. I've seen people that I personally know that got weight loss surgery, lost all the weight in the world, but they were still hopping, they were still hurting, the pain was still there. So it's different people. Some of you guys have got weight loss surgery and you say, the blood pressure pills taken away. I was no longer lipping. I didn't have to take high blood pressure pills anymore. Oh, wonderful. Oh, that is so wonderful that that's what took place with you. But that just doesn't mean that that's what's going to take place with me. Do you guys realize what took place with you doesn't mean it's going to work with me? I just had a friend that had weight loss surgery. Yeah, she did. And she just died too. She just died. Young girl. Died, what, I think like a week after she had a weight loss surgery. Well, I'm not trying to discourage anyone. But, well, they went in and they made a mistake and they punctured her liver. Did they tell her that they punctured her liver? I don't know. So I'm not going to sit here and tell you a lie that I know whether they told her or not. All I know is that she's dead. You know, from weight loss surgery. That she wanted to have and wanted to look so beautiful. Like everybody else, so small and so beautiful. And I watch all of you who have had your weight loss surgery. And I look and I'm like, wow, they look so good. Oh, man, maybe I need to get it. Oh, Lord, they look so good. Yeah, they do look so nice. They look so good. But some people never get to look nice and never look to get so good because they die. Yes, they die. I said it. They die. So for those of you who have got your weight loss surgery, you're doing wonderful, you're doing weight with your weight loss surgery, it's all good. I'm so glad you're doing good. I'm so glad you're doing so wonderful. I'm so glad that God blessed you to come out of your weight loss surgery and everything went well with you. I'm so glad. I'm so honored. Never would I want anybody to go through a surgery and not come out of it. But I'm just fed up with the doctors trying to make me get a weight loss surgery. This is me. This is not you. You know, you can't make me get nothing. Okay, if I have to hop on my knee the rest of my life and pain, okay, I might have to do that. I might have to mumble and groan or whatever. Anybody don't want to hear my groans, then get away from me then. And I'm mad right now. I sure am. I'm mad. So anybody don't want to hear my groans and my moans, that's around me, close people that's around me, friends, relatives, whoever. If you don't want to hear my moans and my groans and you think you can find somebody else or you can find another companion or another friend or another cousin to hang with that ain't groaning, well, then you go ahead and do it. Then do what you got to do. That's all I got to say. So, yeah, I'm pretty mad right now. And then they got their hands out for $20 for me to go in and tell me for $20 that you don't know what's wrong, or for $20 you need a weight loss surgery. I didn't need to come in and pay you $20 to tell me that. And I'm having to see 7 or 8 doctors while I'm here in Cashville. Where am I getting the money from to see 8 or 9 doctors? I'm not working nowhere. Because guess why I'm not working nowhere? Because my body is acting the fool. So I'm not working nowhere. I'm having to rely on other people. When you have to rely on other people for support, nobody knows how that feels. Nobody knows how that feels to have to rely on somebody to give you some money to go and see a doctor or give you some money for some special shoes or whatever that you may need. And you have to ask somebody, can you give me some money because I need this and I need that. And they have to make up their mind and decide if they're going to give you some money or if they're going to do something else with their money that they want to do. So anyway, that's all. I'm just pissed off. I'm pissed off, at the doctors. I'm pissed off at the $20 that you got to keep passing to these doctors. I'm pissed off. And, I'm just saying today, I'm just going to have to depend on God. You know, if I die and leave here, oh, well, I just have to leave here. All of us got to leave here. All of us got to leave sometime or another. But I cannot keep giving $20 for you to go in and tell me the same thing I looked up on the internet. I cannot keep doing it. I cannot keep doing it. And I will not keep giving $20 for you to come and tell me the same thing that I already know. It ain't going to happen. And tell me to go head on in and let the doctor slice me open and twist everything around inside of my body. And me, you telling me to do that. But you're not doing it. But you're telling me to go in and have them to do that to me. This is my body. Okay? So don't tell me what it is that I must get done to my body when this is my body. And then you get mad because I'm not going to have a weight loss surgery. And you mad with me? No, I don't believe that. No, I don't believe that. You mad because I don't want to have a weight loss surgery? Okay, well, when I come to your office, just get your little $20 and tell me the same thing you're going to tell me and let me go. Because don't try to push me to have no weight loss surgery. I have it if I want to. And if I don't want to, I won't. And roundabout right now, I don't want to. Because it's too much going on. It's too much happening. Friends so close and dear to me passing away from weight loss surgery. I ain't feeling that right now. I'm not feeling that right now. Anyway, I'm getting ready to go. I'm out. I'm getting ready to go.